OMG. From a Wolf to a Puppy Novel Audiobook. Chapter 1 to Chapter 4. Xiang Nuannuan, we are still sisters, even if we have different mothers. If you just sleep with Mr. Wang tonight in my place, I'll be able to marry into a rich family. I am only giving you this chance because he demands the woman to be a virgin. If you refuse me, I'll ask Dad to cut off all the financial support your brother is getting for his treatment. And someone will remove his ventilator. Oh, what happens then? That's right, he'll die. Well, the ball's in your court. Xiang Nuannuan stood in front of the presidential suite, with Xiang Qingtian's message to her yesterday still echoing inside her. After that car crash, she lost her mother. And her brother became a vegetable. Over the last 3 years, he had to depend on a ventilator to survive. She was still a university student, so it was impossible for her to afford the costly medical fees. Suddenly, someone opened the door before her, and a hand yanked her into the room. Ah! Xiang Nuannuan jumped in shock, but before she could do anything, she was already pinned against the door. She was terrified and wanted to struggle, but her strength failed her. Damn it! Xiang Qingtian must have spiked my drink earlier. The man in the dark pounced at her as if he was a lion which had found its prey. Ow! Ahhh! She felt as if a truck had rammed into her and broken all of her bones. Every time she moved, pain was the only thing she felt. Even so, she fought through the excruciating agony and opened her eyes. The room was dark and the bed was messy. Clothes littered the floor. She could vaguely see a silhouette beside her, seemingly asleep with his back facing her. Just because Xiang Qingtian wanted to marry into a rich family, she drugged Xiang Nuannuan and gave her up as a sex toy to an old, ugly man. The humiliations she had received overwhelmed her. Without even caring to look at the man closely, she pulled the blanket away and quickly changed into her clothes before dashing out. The moment she stepped out, someone opened the door of the room next to hers. Xiang Qingtian came out in a robe and sneered at Xiang Nuannuan. I knew you'd kick and scream, you little bitch. So I added something to your drink. That saved a lot of time for me. If it wasn't because she had had sex with all her boyfriends too many times that even hymenoplasty was rendered useless, she wouldn't rely on Xiang Nuannuan for help. Xiang Qingtian sneered smugly and went into the room Xiang Nuannuan had escaped from. Xiang Qingtian could still smell the stench of intercourse in the air. The man was still asleep. Carefully, she took off her robe and climbed onto the bed stealthily. When she saw the crimson patch on the bed, she smiled smugly and leaned against the man. You took my virginity away, Mr. Wang. I hope you'll be responsible for this. The man who was sleeping opened his eyes, stood up upon hearing her voice, and glanced at her coldly. You've saved me this time, so name your request. I'll fulfill it. The man had a baritone voice, deep and sexy. Xiang Qingtian was shocked. Wait, this guy is tall and he sounds way too sexy. He's not an ugly fatso. Click. The room lights were turned on, revealing a handsome man. His face looked almost sculpted by Michelangelo himself. And he radiated an elegant vibe no one else could match. What the hell? Xiang Qingtian thought. I know this man. She had seen this man countless times on the TV. He was none other than Yan Tingshen, the president of the Yan Group and young master of the top family in Z Nation. Xiang Nuannuan slept with Yan Tingshen, that little bitch. Back at the Xiang residence, Xiang Qingtian was beaming as she sat quietly beside her father. Xiang Jingong, Dad, this is a big surprise. Don't worry, our family is going to be saved this time. That little bitch is finally useful for once after leeching off from us all these years. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree. It seems, her mother was a slut. So of course her daughter is as much a slut. Servicing our family is an honor for her. Xiang Jingong's expression darkened at the mention of Xiang Nuannuan's mother. HMPH. And she just loves to be a prude. Ha, now that she has lost her virginity, let's see if she can put up this act anymore. That whore has a lot of guts to seduce Jing. Right now she must be dreaming that we'll help her brother. Dream on. Her brother is as good as dead. She's no longer a virgin. So she should feel ashamed to stay in this family. Once she returns, I'll chase her out of our house so your mother won't have to get mad at me over her anymore. Xiang Jingong beamed as he looked at the funds transfer record his assistant gave him. You've helped me a ton this time. Qing Tian, you are a good girl. You are the smarter one here. Dad, not only did you marry me off to a rich and handsome man, you even managed to chase that jinx off. That's what I call hitting two birds with one stone. Click. Someone opened the front door, attracting Xiang Jingong and Xiang Qingtian's attention. Xiang Nuannuan was standing at the doorstep, her face pale and her figure wobbly. She had obviously heard them. It was a devastating shock to her because she had thought this was all Xiang Qingtian's plan. She never expected her father would be behind the scheme as well. Her own father gave her away like she was a sex toy in order to save his company. And as if that wasn't enough, he also planned to use this as an excuse to chase her out of the house. Xiang Jingong was taken aback. How dare you eavesdrop on us? Xiang Nuannuan. Xiang Qingtian quickly calmed him down. Relax. Dad, now that she has heard us, we won't have to waste our time with her. Xiang Nuannuan. From today onward you are no longer welcome here. Pack up and scram. Xiang Nuannuan held her tears back. This villa was given to her mother by her grandfather and was already worth millions more than a decade ago. If this house hadn't been collateralized, Xiang Jingong could never have opened his trading company. My mother left this place for me. So if anyone is supposed to scram, it's you guys. Xiang Nuannuan held back her anger and said coldly. Xiang Jingong stood up angrily. You ingrate. I raised you all these years and this is how you talk to me. Do you really think I won't do anything to you? Ha, you can even give me away like a sex toy all for your other daughter's future. What won't you do, you bastard? H, how dare you? I'll kill you. Xiang Jingong lividly raised his hand. Xiang Nuannuan grabbed his hand. If you are not going to pay for my brother's medical fees, hand over the house. Xiang Jingong sneered. I became the owner of this place when your mother died. If you are smart enough to know what's best for you, you'll get the hell out of here right now. Or else. What? Xiang Nuannuan's sighs widened in disbelief. Xiang Qingtian cackled. Don't get too surprised yet. Bitch. I have something else to tell you. We yanked off your brother's ventilator when you were being pleasured by some random guy. He's probably in the crematorium now, maybe you'll find him in an urn. How dare you? Everything went black and Xiang Nuannuan's legs turned to jelly. 5 years later, at Ninghai General Hospital, a young child said, Mr. Yan, to be specific, a baby can only form once a man penetrates a woman and ejaculates into her. The sperm needs to meet the egg and becomes a zygote before developing into a fetus. A woman alone can't achieve this. Yan Kai was shocked that the four-year-old boy in front of him could be this eloquent, he coughed. So, from where you knew about all this stuff? Xiang Wei Yi blinked at him. I'm not a stupid kid. You know who's stupid? You, because you look stupid. I can't imagine any other reason for your failure in making Xiang Nuannuan your girlfriend even after so many years of trying. Yan Kai coughed. What the hell are you talking about? You little brat. Hey, just shooting straight here. Dummy. Xiang Wei Yi ran out. When the boy returned, he brought back a delicate and pretty young girl who looked exactly like him. Who's our father? Mr. Yan? Yan Kai started having a migraine looking at the gorgeous fraternal twins before him. Xiang Nuannuan was his junior in medical school. So when the Xiang family was in turmoil, Yan Kai introduced a teacher to her and sent her to the States to study. Out of nowhere, Xiang Nuannuan came back last month and brought the fraternal twins with her. This development crushed his plan to court her upon returning from her studies. Even though Xiang Weiyi was only 4 years old, he was a genius with impossibly high intellect. While his younger sister, Xiang Jinjin, was an adorable little girl, anyone who saw her would be captivated by her cuteness. Yan Kai had asked Xiang Nuannuan about the events of the past few years, but as she kept refusing to talk about it, he stopped probing. "Mr. Yan, Xiang Nuannuan told us we were conceived through IVF and you were the surgeon. So you should know who our daddy is, right?" Yan Kai felt flustered. "Why does she have to throw this question to me?" "Ahem. I was the surgeon. Yes. But we had a contract. Unless you both are born with genetic diseases, contractually, none of us can contact your biological father." "Oh, wait, I have a call. Must be my patient. I have to go out for a bit." Yan Kai wanted to evade the question. Xiang Weiyi sneered. "Mr. Yan, your phone screen isn't even lit up. Even if you want to lie to us, at least put in some effort." Xiang Jinjin held her doll and complained to her brother. "Mommy told us only naughty kids lie. You are naughty, Mr. Yan. These kids are really..." "Ugh." When he was at a loss of what to do, sounds of hurried footsteps reached them. A moment later, a white silhouette came in like the wind. "How many times have I told you two not to disturb Mr. Yan?" Xiang Nuannuan picked up her children, wearing a coat. She smiled apologetically at Yan Kai. "Sorry, Kai, I guarantee they won't disturb you anymore." Even though she was a mother of two now, the woman still looked slender. Her face was smooth as if she was just 18. After Xiang Nuannuan apologized to Yan Kai, the phone on the desk rang. "Dr. Yan, the andrology department has a patient who needs immediate attention." "All right, I'll be there right away." Is Dr. Xiang there?" "She is." "Why?" "The patient specifically asked for her once he heard she studied overseas." Yan Kai was stunned. "Dr. Xiang is a lady. So it's inappropriate for her to go." "I'll do it. But the patient is accompanied by the dean. So..." Xiang Nuannuan put her kids down. "I'll take a look. Kai, I majored in psychology. But that didn't mean I didn't study Chinese medicine." "Fine, but I'll go with you to see if I can help." Xiang Nuannuan smiled. Then she glared at her son and threatened him. "Xiang Weiyi, you'd better stay here and look after your sister before I come back. Don't go anywhere else." Xiang Weiyi gave her a smug grin. But then he stood up straight. "I will complete this mission." Even though he was mischievous, the boy would do whatever he had promised others. After her son had given his guarantee, Xiang Nuannuan left without a worry. However, the moment they left, Xiang Jinjin said to her brother, "Weiyi, mommy said we can't just go through someone else's stuff." "Ah, shut up. You want to find daddy or not?"
"I do, I do."
"Then shut up. But can you find daddy by playing computer games?" "Ha, this is the latest remote control system. If daddy's information is in this computer, I can find him."
"You are awesome, Weiyi. SHH, shut up, the VIP room. We have a lot of kinky people lately. I heard that the guy was having sex with his girlfriend when they got too excited. And the car rolled down the mountain. I heard he hurt his penis. TSK. The head nurse was giving a briefing about the situation and opened the door while Xiang Nuannuan read through the records. The moment she saw the name Gu Shu Jing on the record, her expression changed. She looked up. A young girl in her early 20s was sitting beside the bed, her face still flushed as she leaned in the man's arms. "Do you still hurt down there, Jing? What if it can't get up anymore?"
"Don't worry. I can still make sure you are pleasured even if it doesn't get up."
"You pervert." The woman thumped his chest. When she looked up and saw Xiang Nuannuan at the door, the woman's expression changed.
I thought I was seeing things when I saw your name in the lobby. So it really is you. How dare you come back to Ninghai City, Xiang Nuannuan? Gu Shujing was Xiang Nuannuan's boyfriend in university, while Liu Mengyin used to be her best friend. Back then, Xiang Jinggong wanted to cut off all financial support for her sickly brother, so she fought against him. If it wasn't because she stumbled upon her boyfriend cheating on her with her best friend, she wouldn't be dejected enough to seek help from Xiang Qingtian. Xiang Nuannuan would not have fallen into her trap and lost her virginity. You cheated on me while you f**ked my boyfriend behind my back. If someone as shameless as you two can stay in this city, why can't I come back? I am the victim after all. Xiang Nuannuan exposed them mercilessly. Gu Shujing's expression changed. Who are you calling shameless? Xiang Nuannuan smiled. If the shoe fits. Liu Mengyin quickly tugged at Gu Shujing. Do you think I don't know what you did? Xiang Nuannuan, stop putting on that prude act. Your sister told us what you did. You are just a used item. Someone who would sleep with a fat, ugly old man for Slap. Xiang Nuannuan gave Liu Mengyin a tight slap, leaving a mark on her face. Shocked, it took Liu Mengyin a while to process what had just happened before she covered her face in disbelief. How dare you slap me? Xiang Nuannuan rotated her wrist languidly and smiled with innocence. Whoops. Sorry for that. My hand itches for a good slap whenever it comes across bitches who wouldn't shut up. Aw, are you hurt, sweetie? Why you? Liu Mengyin was enraged. But she didn't want to show the wench within her with Gu Shujing around. So she leaned against him. Gu Shujing's expression darkened. I did not expect you to be this kind of woman. Xiang Nuannuan, you pretended to be gentle and oh so innocent in front of me and didn't even allow me to touch you. But what did you do behind me? You are nothing but a wench. A prostitute everyone can have their ways with. Looks like I was right to have cheated on you. Xiang Nuannuan almost cackled from anger. This is the first I've heard someone justifying their cheating with such a fresh reason. Why you? The head nurse felt that it was getting out of control. So she quickly stepped in. Let's leave catching up to another day. Will you check on Mr. Gu? Liu Mengyin stopped messing around. For Gu Shujing's injury could cost her sex life if left untreated. Xiang Nuannuan toned down the aggression and looked at the bandage on the man's waist as she listened to the nurse report about the details. He used too much force. And it's filled with blood. Must have sprained it during the fall. So it worsened the blood flow there. Not too much of a problem. Just stay at the hospital for a couple of days for observation and he'll be fine. Liu Mengyin stood up with doubt. You didn't even take a look. So how do you know? Xiang Nuannuan glanced at her. It's filthy. I don't want to look at it. Why you? Liu Mengyin and Gu Shujing choked on their own words. Xiang Nuannuan smiled. Arrange for his admission. Head nurse. My job here is done. She then went out without hesitation. Yan Kai was standing outside the door all this time. Planning to help once Xiang Nuannuan got into trouble. But his junior seemed to be tougher than he thought. Instead of her being bullied, the patient and his lover seemed to be the ones who were humiliated. When he was about to catch up with her, Liu Mengyin came out. I'm warning you, Xiang Nuannuan, don't think Jing will come back to you because you came back. I'm getting engaged to him soon. I tell you, I'm pregnant. PFFT. Xiang Nuannuan turned around and smiled lazily. Did all the Botox get into your head? Why are you telling me that? I'm not the one who got you pregnant. Liu Mengyin's jaw dropped. A while later, she touched her face awkwardly. Is it that obvious? But then she quickly realized that Xiang Nuannuan was mocking her. So she gnashed her teeth in anger. She gave it a thought and quickly called someone. Hey, Qingtian, guess who I bumped into at Ninghai General Hospital? Back when she was in the States, Xiang Nuannuan had to take care of her kids, work, and study at the same time. Every day was hectic for her. She would often skip meals and had since developed gastric pains. Every time she was angered, her body would act up. When she saw her ex and her cheating friend, her stomach was already complaining. The pain had spread by the time she came out of the room. Everything spun around her. She held her stomach as she slowly went back to her office to take her medication. Two tall, slender men came walking in her direction from not far away. The old man had his checkup. And everything's okay. The problem here is you. Hey, the andrology department is up ahead. And it's famous for its team and facilities. Do you want to, have yourself checked there? Ha ha ha. Shen Xichen teased. He thought he would get beaten up after that. But the tall, handsome man beside him said nothing and suddenly stopped walking. When he was about to turn around, Shen Xichen saw someone about to lean on Yan Tingshen. A woman. Shen Xichen was shocked. For Yan Tingshen never flirted around. Neither did he allow any woman to approach him. She's going to get it. However, what happened next shocked him. Yan Tingshen actually hugged the woman. Xiang Nuannuan was surprised to find herself in someone's embrace. She looked up and saw a man in black suit right in front of her. His eyes were deep set. His features perfect. His vibe noble. Sorry. Xiang Nuannuan paled and took a few steps back. However, the man stared at her and refused to let her go. Sir. Xiang Nuannuan blushed when she felt his hand starting to roam all over her. Please behave yourself and let me go. Tingshen. Shen Xichen rubbed his eyes, thinking he was seeing things. Is this the Tingshen I know? He doesn't look like a man without desire now. All he did was hold her. And now he isn't letting her go. As if noticing his rude behavior, Yan Tingshen quickly let go. Xiang Nuannuan was about to scold him, but her stomach was killing her. She could only lean against the wall, panting. Xiang Nuannuan, an angry, childish voice roared from the end of the corridor. When Xiang Nuannuan turned back, she saw her son coming over angrily. His cheeks puffed. He stuffed a small bottle of white pills into her hand. You know your stomach will act up. So why didn't you take your meds with you? Can't you just let me live 1 second of my life without worrying about you? Why are adults getting harder to discipline? Even though Xiang Weiyi was livid, he looked worried. He held his mother and slowly brought her back to the office. Why are you still standing here? Tingshen. Shen Xichen waved his hand before Yan Tingshen. The man snapped out of a trance and looked down at his hands. That woman just now. The feeling when I held her. And that slender figure. They felt so familiar. And that boy. He thought about something. Then the man looked back. Xiang Weiyi was still moving forward. But then he sensed something and suddenly looked back. As their gazes met, the atmosphere started to turn bizarre. Tingshen. I know she's pretty and she has a hot body. But don't you think that would scare her away? Xiang Nuannuan. He had spotted her name tag when she fell into his embrace just now. She's a psychiatrist. Huh. But if I'm correct, she came from the andrology department. What are you trying to do? Tingshen. You said the andrology department here is famous in our country. Right? Huh. I was just joking. Don't take it seriously. Tingshen. Make an appointment for me. What? Shen Xichen thought he heard something ludicrous. He stood still, processing what he had been told. As Yan Tingshen walked on, is Tingshen for real? Shit. What are you doing? Wei Yi. Xiang Jinjin came into her brother's room with a doll in hand. She looked at her brother who was typing away at the keyboard, looking confused. Did you find daddy? Wei Yi. Xiang Wei Yi was frowning, his expression grim. At this moment, he was controlling Yan Kai's PC from afar and managed to track down the folder in which he kept the records of IVF procedures he had done. Inside were 10 years worth of patients. but none contained Xiang Nuannuan's record. HMPH. Xiang Weiyi slammed his laptop angrily. Did mommy lie to me? Xiang Jinjin pouted when her brother's temper flared. Then she bawled. I want daddy. I want daddy. I want daddy. Xiang Weiyi thought about it. An inspiration struck him. Then he hopped down from the chair. Hey, Xiang Jinjin. Do you want a tall, handsome, and rich daddy? What does rich mean? Weiyi. It means he can buy you a lot of dolls and buy mommy a lot of pretty clothes. He can also bring us to taste all the food we want in the world. Yay. Of course I want that. Alright. Then we're gonna do this tomorrow. Listen closely. Suddenly, the door opened. Xiang Nuannuan poked her head in. Hey, it's 9 o'clock now. Go to sleep, both of you. Xiang Weiyi winked at his sister. Then he jumped onto his bed. Xiang Jinjin wasn't as brave as her brother was. So she slept with her mother. She liked to lie on her mother's chest and listen to her heartbeat while drifting to sleep. As Dreamlin waved its hand at her, the girl mumbled, Daddy. Xiang Nuannuan looked down and saw her daughter sound asleep. She bit her lip and brushed the girl's face. 2 months after she went overseas to study under Yan Kai's recommendation, she found out she was pregnant. Even more surprisingly, she was pregnant with twins. Maybe Mr. Wang had fertile seeds. Or maybe she was the fertile one. Xiang Nuannuan wanted to get an abortion. But she was in a country where abortion was possible only if her family signed the papers. Since she had no family, she took the fetuses to term. It was lucky that her children were gorgeous. One was smart, and the other was cute. They brought colors to her monochrome life. My children, I don't want to lie to you, but your father is a dark past of mine, so I can't have you go looking for him. I'm sorry. As guilt overwhelmed her, her phone suddenly rang. Yan Kai was calling her. She took her phone and quietly went to the balcony. Kai. The higher ups gave us a sudden order. You might have to go to Yujingshan District tomorrow for a checkup. Yujingshan District. That's the most affluent place in the city. No matter how rich you are, you can't buy a house at that spot if you don't have power. It is a psychological condition. They didn't say. But since they specifically asked for you, it should be right up your alley. Xiang Nuannuan was feeling weird about this. For there was no record of any Ninghai General Hospital doctor giving checkups outside of the hospital's premises. Though what Yan Kai said next swept all the suspicions she had. If you manage this successfully, you'll have a triple bonus this month. Xiang Nuannuan's eyes lit up at the mention of bonus. I'll complete this task successfully. After sending her kids off to kindergarten the next day, Xiang Nuannuan took her medical kit and rushed to Yujingshan District. The moment she arrived, she was welcomed by the patient's assistant, Yuan Shu. Are you Dr. Xiang? Yuan Shu's expression was inscrutable, but he was polite. Yes, that is me. Xiang Nuannuan nodded and followed him into the villa. May I know who my patient for the day is? He's my boss. You can call him Mr. Yan. If it's possible, may I know about Mr. Yan's current condition? Where is he hurt? Yuan shook off. I think you should ask him for the details. Doctor. Xiang Nuannuan thought it was a difficult one this time. Judging by how hesitant Yuan Shu was. Could it be schizophrenia? When Yuan Shu brought her to the study, Yan Tingshen was sitting behind his big desk, seemingly handling some documents. The sunlight shone on him from the window behind, coating him in a golden sheen. His face was impeccable, and he gave a sense of aloofness and nobility. Thanks for listening to the Bravonovel audiobook. Welcome to download the Bravonovel app. Read the novel OMG. From a Wolf to a Puppy online and get the latest updates. Please see the video introduction for the novel details page and app download address.